Greetings, explorers. Today, we are going to visit an old-school egg farm. But why an old-fashioned one and not a modern one? Because unlike the modernised factory farms, as they call it, this one is more traditional, closer to nature, sustainable, very low carbon footprint, therefore more environment friendly. On regular day-to-day operations, this farm don't use antibiotics, pesticides, rodenticides and disinfectants unless it's really needed. Why? Simple, it's both expensive and harmful to the environment. How they did it? Let's go and see. A commercial layer poultry farm is what people in the agriculture industry call it, while we consumers just call it an egg farm or whatever we like to call it. This one has been operating since 1991, and it is a multi-age farm. Meaning, you can find day-old chicks, growers, pre-layers, and layer hens all raised together in one farm complex. To a Western veterinarian, it is a biosecurity nightmare. However, it is common practice here in the Philippines. Before an egg can be produced, all has to start at day one, the day old chicks, arrived from a hatchery within 24 hours upon hatching. These day old chicks are 99% females. Males end up here, simply because of errors during gender classification. Males are not raised here since males' chickens don't lay eggs. And yes, hens don't need males to lay eggs. In this rather small building they called the brooding house, these chicks will stay here for the next 35 days, given the utmost care possible, for they are the future layers, making sure they had enough liquids, feeds, and the right room temperature. Here they don't use any thermometers. Instead, they observe the chick's body language, which accurately tells the farmer if it's too hot or too cold. At this stage, this flock will receive vaccines against different types of poultry diseases once or twice weekly via drinking water, injected, or eye drop. At 10 days old, their beaks are being trimmed down. This is to ensure that peaking will not become lethal. Non-trimmed beaks are sharp and can easily puncture skin and muscle tissue. Is left unchecked, could result to mortality as high as 20%. Within seconds after their beaks are trimmed, they can immediately feed and drink as if nothing happened. On their second stage of development, the birds are transferred to another house, known as the growing house. This is where the flock will spend their next 11 weeks. Eating, drinking and sleeping is all they do for now. Same as before, they are treated like queens, making them as comfortable as possible. On the third stage of their life is when they will repay the farmer's hospitality by laying him eggs. These birds are German breed white leghorns, which has the genetic potential to lay around 350 eggs. When they reach the age of 80 weeks, layers are what the industry call these birds now. At their peak, they can lay an egg every 25 hours. As the hen ages, rate of lay starts to decline. On this farm, almost nothing is mechanized. Hens are fed by hands, water distributed by gravity, and eggs manually harvested one by one. After the eggs are harvested, it is then graded by weight. Soiled, cracked and broken eggs are separated and sold for other uses. This machine can sort up to 10,000 eggs per hour. Layers are fed mainly with grains, mainly yellow corn, wheat and soybean meal. Vitamins and minerals are also added into the feed, as these birds demand very high nutrition as they lay egg. Imagine giving birth every 25 hours. On this farm, artificial lighting is provided only 5 hours a day during night time, while factory farms needs to provide 16 hours of artificial lighting. Hens needs light to stimulate egg lay. If daylight is too short, which occurs naturally during winter seasons, chickens will cease to lay eggs. So to ensure layer hens lays eggs whole year round, artificial lighting is provided. On factory farms where birds are kept so crowded, they need an artificial controlled environment where the temperature, humidity and airflow is controlled mainly with large ventilation fans, running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But here is all natural. Birds can feel the breeze and get sunshines in times of the day. The use of electricity at this farm is at minimum. At this farm, nothing goes to waste. Even the birds' manure are sold as fertilizers. Droppings are managed well. It is dry and ready to be bagged. From time to time, it is sprayed with AMO, Indigenous microorganism, which is cultivated within the farm complex. It contains billions of beneficial bacteria, yeast and fungi, which aid in biodegradation, bioleaching and nitrogen fixation. As a result, reducing the smell of droppings to almost barely noticeable. Instead of giving antibiotics to prevent disease, birds are vaccinated regularly. Here, we see it done via Coarse spray. It is very safe and won't stress the birds. Antibiotics residues can accumulate in the egg when administered to laying hens. To control the weeds on the farm, goats are used instead of lawn mowers and herbicide. Pesticides are also not used. Instead, their natural predators are introduced, such as these staphylinid beetles and Carcinops pumilio beetles, which preys on flies' larvae and eggs. Cats are natural predators of rats, so it's no surprise that the farm housed so many of them. After seeing this, what do you think? Is it a sustainable egg farm or not? Let us know in the comment below. Subscribe to see more videos like this in the future.